You want to find out more information, go to tryhockeyforfree.com. It's tryhockeyforfree.com. It's always a great opportunity. Ever been on a pair of ice skates and you kind of wonder what it's all about? You get a chance to do it for free. And that is going to take place, I guess, at the Dipper. So the Big Dipper next weekend. So it should be a lot of fun. Lake State, Fair State, Michigan Tech taking on Northern Michigan. So it could come down to our Anchorage and Fair as far as going to play.
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot of scoreboard watching. Nanook will kind of know where they stand heading in to both Friday and Saturday night's game next week. For UAA, again, needing pretty much two victories and some help next weekend. To get into the playoffs, sitting there with only 26 points.
Out of town score tonight. We got a final for you. Fairbanks Ice Dogs, a 3-2 winner after losing last night 5-1. They win tonight 3-2 over the Minnesota Magicians. They'll be heading to Illinois to take on the Springfield Junior Blues next weekend in North American Hockey League play. The Ice Dogs, a couple of weeks ago, out of the playoff hunt. They're now in third place in the Midwest Division of the North American Hockey League standings. Made quite a run, winning 9 of their past 10 games, and I think it's 10 out of the last 12, so they've certainly made up some ground in the league standings. Captain Morgan checking in, listening to the voice of the Nanooks, and Eric Dragas from Honolulu, Hawaii. Congratulations, seniors and Alaska alum. Captain Morgan checking in. We've had some folks have some issues with the KCBF computer stream, trying to get on the KCBF on the computer. We know that the phone app is working through the app store. Just type in 820sports.com or KCBF. I've got that my phone, so obviously Captain Morgan is able to listen to our broadcast from Honolulu, Hawaii. And we do apologize again. The WCHA stream, apparently some issues back at the Stretch Web Center. We're able to get the signal out of our building, but they're unable to get it down there and broadcast it out worldwide through Stretch. So we do apologize on that. So kind of a tough night all around, as this is a big, big game, and folks are catching us on the stream with either 820sports.com or through the WYSS ESFM 99.5 stream in Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan. Earlier today, college basketball, the Alaska Nanook women, a 56-41 win against the SMU team from Boise, Idaho. So they now go to 9-9 in the conference, 13-12 overall. And that is certainly a good night for the Alaska Nanooks.
Okay. Well, senior night here again tonight. There are four seniors leaving us. Brandon Morley, the captain, played here with his brother, older brother, Tyler Morley. Brandon Morley with 37 points in his career. Josh Erickson, assistant captain, 24 career points, and Marcus Passara leading the team this season with 19 points. 19 points is your top scorer. You're just having a hard time finding a net, but 87 career points from Marcus Passara. And then Davis Jones in net tonight, looking for his fifth win of the season. His career record, 22 wins, 34 losses, and 5 ties in 62 games played.
He has been a real good workhorse the second half of the season. as they have done a very, very good job of getting back into the playoff hunt. Nanox were down toward the bottom of the standings there for a bit, and they've been able to move up now. You know, this is a team that was picked to finish dead last by the coaches, eighth by the media. Right now they're sitting in the number six spot, a chance to move up to maybe number five, and mathematically still alive for number four, but like I say, it's probably going to be tough.
Yeah, I think one of the reasons they were picked so low is how young they are, how young they were going to be this season. A lot of freshmen, a lot of sophomores, and just you don't know how they're going to come in and perform, and it's not a lot of expectations around the league for the Nanox, and they have had inconsistencies. I think that pretty much sums up the season. It's just inconsistent. You see flashes, you know, where you're like, oh man, they're going to go on a tear and, you know, maybe move up in the, you know, home ice for the playoff hunt, and then all of a sudden they'll hit the skids for two or three games, and it's just been a lot of inconsistencies throughout the season. Forwards, defensemen, and goaltenders, and it's growing pains, and I think by this time in the year they were hoping they'd be a little further ahead, but they find themselves still in the playoff hunt. Like you said, still a chance for home ice. It's one of those seasons, only four seniors and a lot of young kids in the lineup.
My app was working. All right, we've just been given a note here from WCHA-TV. The Alaska Nanox are going to post. Apparently, they've got a backup plan right now. If you go to alaskanetics.com, they're posting a link to get to the WCHA-TV site for period number three. So, again, if you go to alaskanetics.com, and you'll be able to get that to link to get to WCHA-TV. So go to alaskanetics.com, and they're going to link it.
What's that?
And they're also doing it on Facebook and Twitter. So if you check the I actually put the link on, or I put the information on Facebook. It's going to be on Twitter, too. So if you're looking to get to the third period on WCHA-TV, either go to alaskanetics.com, and you can also go to Twitter or Facebook. So. Boy, just all kinds of things happening up here in the booth. These guys have been scrambling up here trying to get the WCHA TV to work, but it's not anything out of the Carlson Center here. It's obviously something going on back at the Stretch headquarters, unable to get that thing rebroadcasted out. Nonetheless, a 3-1 hockey game, Alaska over Lake State, and we will take a 3-minute timeout and bring it back for the start of period number three. With a score, Alaska 3 and Lake State 1, back in 3 minutes on the simulcast at 99.5 ESFM, ESPN Radio, 820 Sports. Stream live at 820sports.com.
It's been a cold winter, but the deals at Seekins Ford Lincoln are really hot. What do you need? What is it that you want? Small to large, four-wheel drive, all-wheel drive, new or used? Our President's Day blowout sale puts you in the car, SUV, or truck you really want to deserve at prices you can't afford not to take advantage of. So even if you're thinking of a new or different vehicle, you need to check out our President's Day sale at Seekins Ford Lincoln today.
It's time once again for
Name That Wood Stove!
According to the EPA's own website, who builds the most efficient wood stoves on the planet?
Blaze King?
Correct! Next question, what is the best-selling wood stove in interior Alaska?
Blaze King?
Correct again! This contestant's on fire! One more, why do people love the Blaze King?
Burns longer, burns less wood, easy to use! Chimney stays cleaner.
Buy your Blaze King at the Woodway.
The Alaska Nanox would like to thank all their great corporate sponsors, including Pike's Waterfront Lodge, Capital Office Systems, Fairbanks Memorial Hospital, Fairbanks Natural Gas, Arctic Chiropractic, the exclusive sponsor of our mascot Nook, JL Properties, Kinross Fort Knox, TDL Staffing, The Alaska Club, UA College Savings Plan, Usabelli Coal Mine, Utility Services of Alaska, and Wells Fargo Subway, an official sponsor of the Junior Nanook program.
For more than 20 years, Christopher Dean, certified athletic trainer at Sports Medicine Fairbanks, has been a fixture on the sidelines, at the rink, or in the gym, providing personalized medical care for Fairbanks athletes and a proud alumni of the University of Alaska Fairbanks. He works diligently in our community and to restore athletes to their peak performance following injury.
Hi, this is Christopher Dean from Sports Medicine Fairbanks. I've been very blessed to work with Fairbanks' athletes for all these years, and would like to wish all the athletes, coaches, and community members a safe, fulfilling holiday season.
Stop worrying about Valentine's Day. The Pump House Restaurant has it covered with a new menu, special desserts, fine wine, and champagne, and the most romantic atmosphere in town. Call now for reservations. Let the Pump House make Valentine's dinner special so you can just be yourself. The Pump House Restaurant and Saloon. Call 479-8452 for reservations.
The Pump House Restaurant Saloon. Why go anywhere else? Call us at 479-8452 or visit us online at pumphouse.com.
Nutrisource Super Premium Pet Foods, available at Cold Spot for Healthy Pets. Nutrisource Pet Food is highly digestible for maximum nutrient absorption. Their pet diets are also nutritionally complete, so more of the concentrated nutrition is retained by your pet. This means you can feed your pet less, as much as two-thirds less than other brands. And by feeding smaller, more easily digestible portions, your pet produces less waste. Nutrisource Super Premium Pet Foods, available at Cold Spot for Healthy Pets.
You're listening to Live Alaska Nanook's Hockey on ESPN 820 Sports.
All right, David Kalita's listening to our broadcast somewhere at 7 o'clock in the morning, somewhere back east. And we're now told that the Nanook stream is working at YouTube. So what, do they have to go to Alaska Nanook's YouTube? Or just go to YouTube and punch up UAF Hockey. So go to YouTube, UAF Hockey, and the WCHA stream has been moved over to there. So there you go.
How many places is it? I mean, geez.
I don't know what's going on. It's crazy, man. It's
so many places, you don't know where to find it. I mean,
seriously. Well, they're having some issues on the normal link, so they've adjusted it to YouTube, I guess. All right, here we go. Nanook's Rod Schotten at second period, 10-8, a 21-16 shot advantage for Lake State, but Alaska leading 3-1. Lakers now with a big third period start as they start the period on the power play. They dump it to the corner. Erickson will pick it up now for Alaska. Erickson trying to clear it out, locked along the boards. Left side of goaltender Davis Jones. Hultz will pick it up. Mitch Hultz back out top now for Bendulis. Back for Hultz. Hultz down low to the goal line. They'll work with it. Back out top. Spinning around is Terrell, getting it back to Hultz. Hultz now back for Bendulis. Traffic out front. Here's Luke Morgan getting it back for Bendulis. Bendulis in the circle right out front. Jones steers that to the corner, picked up again by Hultz. Hultz has the puck. Hultz now between the circles. He puts a shot. Davis Jones makes a save. Loose to the side of the cage. Picked up by Koberstein. He'll dump it up and dump it down. And now the net's knocked off the mooring. Who bumped it out? Looks like the faceoff's going to come to, let's see. Looks like left side of Davis Jones.
Unfortunate break for the Nanooks. Jones able to make a save there. Go from his right to his left, and Koberstein cleared it down the ice. But the faceoff's going to come back to the left of Davis Jones. Still 27 seconds left on Brandon Morley's minor penalty.
All right, so they'll take some time to adjust here. 53 seconds into the third period of play. Stay tuned for the post-game press conference coming up following tonight's contest. Henke on the draw now against Taylor Munson. They drop it. We're going to have to drop it again as those guys were not lined up correctly. So one more time, go to YouTube, Alaskan Addicts. You'll be able to get the WCHA TV feed tonight. Our phone app is definitely working at 820sports.com, KCBF on the phone app. We understand there's been a little bit of an issue trying to get to the computer. It's going to a GoDaddy.com link or something, but if you got the phone app, you'll be able to get to 820. And of course, WYSS 99.5. Yes FM in Sault Ste. Marie also has a link. I believe it's yesfm.net. You'll be able to listen to the broadcast there too. 18:45 to go, third period. Final seconds tick down, penalties over, and the Lakers 0-2 in the power play. Nanook's are back at full strength. Kristen Thompson picks it up. Into the corner, takes a shot from Humitz. Humitz now takes a shot from Thompson. Help now from Troy Van Tienering. Humitz out top now for Wright. Swings it over for Sackerman. Sackerman shot blocked down by Morley. Sackerman gets it right back, trying to get it to the side of the net there for Henke. Tied up nicely there by Thompson. All the action right side of the goal. Play back to the point. Here's Sackerman with a shot. Edster just wide. Up the ice now for Humitz. He shoots and he scores. And now the Lakers close within 3-2. Upstairs in the far side of the goal, I think over the left shoulder of goaltender Davis Jones. And credit the goal to Max Humitz. And all of a sudden, we got us a hockey game now. 3-2. Lakers pull within one. An even strength goal coming up at 1:51 of period number three.
Well, Lakers did what they needed to do. Just get that puck on net and get on the board early. So you're not fighting, trying to score
13th goal of the season for number 21. 3-2.
Lake Superior State goals 13th of the season, scored by number 21, Max Humitz, assisted by number 23, Colin Sackerman. Having that even strength goal, 1 minute, 51 seconds of the third period.
So 3-2 hockey game and a lot of hockey to go. Just 2 minutes into the third period of play. Here's Colton Leader getting it back now toward Kyler Hope. Back toward the point for Corelli. Knocked loose now by Diego Cuglietta. Cuglietta tied up. Woods will pick it up and clear it back to Leader. Onside now, and here comes Ross Height. Height comes in with a shot on goal and a save made by the goaltender, Gordy Dayfield. Meantime, Nanuk trying to crash the net there. Kyler Hope knocks the net up the mooring. The net's pushed all the way back to the back wall there, and Hope will come over to the bench, and he'll be okay. These guys are giving it all they got right now. A lot on the line, 3 points on the line. Lakers starting the night tied for seventh with 31 points with Northern Michigan. Nanuk's in sole possession of the number six spot, trying to get closer to number five. Taylor nice. Munson on the draw now against Max Humitz.
With that goal for the Lakers.
Mitch Holt.
This game has tightened up. You can tell on the ice, nobody wanted to make a mistake as they try to get points.
Terrell with a shot. He actually worked it out there for number 16. Mitch Holtzow with a shot on goal and a save made by Davis Jones. Nanuk's turned it to a two-on-one opportunity out front there, and Staley could not take the pass there from Tyler Klein. Klein picks it back up. Klein works out front, right in goal. Dayfield makes a save, and the puck squirts all the way back in the Nanuk defensive zone. Both teams with great scoring chances. Koberstein behind his own net. Holtz will push him back now and then peel back and go to the bench, make a line change. Three down, third period, 3-2. Alaska Nanuk leading the Lake State Lakers. Nellis trying to take a pass from Morgan. Nanuk's take it away. They come back 2-on-2. Riker Lear had it poke checked away and then gets it right back. And knocked out center ice by Nellis. Nellis takes a shot to the bench here by James Leduce. Morgan and Lear collide with it. All the action to the side of the Nanuk net. Lookout working out front is Henke. And I think Davis Jones may have gotten a piece of that one, or it was fired a bit high. Kept in the left wall. Back out top for Aiden Wright. Right shot. Davis Jones blocks that to the corner with traffic out front. Lakers with a little jump on their step here as they've closed within 3-2. 3.5 down. Period 3. Nanuk's back the other way, but Henke will intercept and then reclaimed by Leduce. He'll play it back to Zach Fry. Fry now will get a good look up the ice. The assistant captain from Spokane, Washington. Dumps it to Lear, who clears it in. And now the puck picked up by McCardle. He'll clear it back to Chatham. Up to Diego Cuglietta. Intercepted Nanuk. There's an opportunity for Troy Van Tittering. His pass missed there to Mullally. In transition, Cuglietta back the other way. Side of the far faceoff circle. Dishes off now for Gelsinger. Gelsinger back for Cuglietta. Cuglietta takes a bump there from Staley, or make it Tristan Thompson. Thompson now falling on top of the puck there as it's cleared loose. Brought out now by Marcus Passara. Up for Troy Van Tittering. That pass a tad too far. Renzo cleared back in defensively for Lake State. Jones behind his net. He'll drop it back now to Tristan Thompson. Thompson back over to Justin Woods. Woods will clear the zone. Intercepted by Gus Corielli. Corielli back the other way. Corielli shot on goal. Save made Davis Jones. Corielli tracks it back down and takes it back behind the net now for Max Humitz. Humitz with the puck. Humitz controls it. Gets it back now for Renz. Renz back for Humitz. To Holtz, I should say. Holtz now getting it back to Corielli. Gus Corielli behind the net. Out front, trying to get it for Sackerman, kept in by Gage Terrell. Terrell in the corner. Bassara takes it away. And now Woods, high off the glass, dumps it out to the neutral ice area. Bendulis back to track it down. 14:55 to go, third period. Alaska Nanuk 3, Lake Superior State Lakers 2. Brandon Morley picks up the errant pass. He'll skate back behind the Nanuk net. And the Nanuk captain with his parents in the stand here. We'll get it back to Danny Corelli. Erickson's parents here too on senior weekend. Takeaway now by Morgan. Look out. Luke Morgan skates with it, looking for a trailer out front. There's a shot and a save made by Davis Jones. Still dangerous in front. Now back right point position to Sackerman. Gets it left side for Bendulis. Bendulis with an opportunity. Davis Jones clears it to the wall. Picked up now by Brandon Morley. Morley looks for an opportunity to clear it out. Good job by the Lakers to keep it in. They'll get it back to Bendulis at the left point. Almost a takeaway there by Brandon Morley, and he does take it out to center ice. Good job by Brandon Morley. Morley dishes off now for Corelli. Corelli with a shot right on goal and a save made by the goaltender, Gordy Dayfield. 14:04 to go in the third. We get a media timeout. We'll keep it right here. 3-2 Alaska Nanuk.
few turnovers there in the defensive zone. And Lakers with some good opportunities. Davis Jones making a really good save on the last one, getting a glove on that. And defense able to clear it out from the front of the net.
Well, teams get a chance to get a breather right now. Again, we'll be in Anchorage next weekend as we'll play our third and fourth games against UAA. 6 points on the line in the WCHA standings. Anchorage in a must-win type of situation now as they find themselves in the basement right now with 26 league points. They are basically 5 points out of the playoffs right now. They're going to have to roll the dice and get some help to get in the playoffs. Of course, Ananux want to win the Governor's Cup and pick up some more points. The series is tied at 1-1 after both teams split the first two games of the series back here in Fairbanks in December.
Ananux also picked up a win earlier in the season against the Seawolves. A lot of us thought it was part that they were going to counter the Governor's Cup, but it did not.
Yeah, we got some confusion. We're working about it next year, too, trying to figure it out.
That was way back on October 8th, 4-1 victory.
That was where both teams took on the Minnesota Golden Gophers, kind of the modified tournament that Anchorage used to have. Here comes Chad Staley, along with Klein, taken away by Luke Morgan. Morgan up now for Nellis. Nellis will carry in the zone, works past Staley. Nellis with a shot that's high and off the mark. Kept in, though, by Aiden Wright. Back to Henke. Henke fanned on it. JT Henke now lost it. Nellis gets it back. Ananux will strip it loose, and the puck is cleared out now by Tyler Klein. 13:25 and counting, third period. Alaska Ananux 3, Lake Superior State Lakers 2. Shot back in. Icing call against Lake Superior State. We want to thank a lot of folks who made a donation to the UA Foundation for all things Alaska Ananux hockey, helping our radio broadcast. A big thanks to the Alaska Laborers Local 942, Political and Education Committee, Mary Ann and Doug Tansey. Thank you very much. Fairbanks Central Labor Council, the AFL-CIO, and the United Food and Commercial Workers, Local 1496. My crew over at Safeway, thank you guys for making donations to the UA Foundation for all things Alaska Ananux hockey. We got a penalty coming up here. Interference call. And it's going to go against the Lake Superior State Lakers, Aiden Wright. Power play chance number two for Alaska. And a chance to get another goal on the scoreboard here, leading 3-2. 6:46 will be the time of the infraction against number 22.
Box 4, Lake Superior State is number 22, Aiden Wright. 2 minutes interference. That's number 22, Wright. A 2 minute minor interference. That call assessed to 6 minutes, 44 seconds of the third period. That'll put your Ananux on the Kindle Subaru Power Play.
Morley, Van Teetering, Basara up top, and defensively it's Woods and Corelli. Lakers have the draw. Chanham along the wall for Gus Corielli. Corielli's going to be able to clear it up and clear it down, so Corelli back to track it down. 7 minutes down, period number three, Alaska 3 and Lake State 2. Both these teams split a two-game set in Sault Ste. Marie earlier this season. Ananux needing overtime to win their contest. Here's McCardle losing it to Marcus Basara. Van Teetering, Troy Van Teetering in a battle with it. Now back to Tyler Morley. Make that Brandon Morley. Wish we had Tyler. Back out to Corelli. Corelli now back for Basara. Marcus Basara pushed down to the ice by Corielli. Kept alive. Back to the point for Danny Corelli. Corelli skates with it, getting it back to Marcus Basara. Basara now back to the point position, and Woods can't keep it onside. Now they're going to wait to tag up, get onside. They will do so, brought in by Troy Van Teetering. Van Teetering does a good job to stick handle with it. Back to the point for Woods. Woods at that left point. He'll pinch in deep. Woods now with a shot from a tough angle, high and just off the mark. And that puck is still kept alive now behind the net. Picked up in the corner now by McCardle. He'll flip it up. Woods will keep it in at the right point position. Right out front on the stick of Chanham. He'll shoot it down and shoot it up the ice. 45 on the power play for Alaska. 8 minutes into the third, 12 to play in regulation. It's Alaska 3 and Lake State 2. Dayfield over to Ben Tulis. Terrell shoots it up and shoots it down. Time for another rush here for Alaska's Fry. And Thompson will work it out of their own zone. Zach Fry comes up with a two. Tristan Thompson up along the wall and cleared in nicely there by Tyler Klein. He was hooked down as the Lakers pick it back up. Terrell comes back the other way, snuck past the defense, and a penalty coming up to Zach Fry. Boy, Terrell was able to somehow get back behind defender Zach Fry and came in with a scoring opportunity, forcing Fry to take a penalty. That could have been a short-handed game-tying goal opportunity there. It was for the Lakers.
Well, Nanook thought that they should have a penalty called on the Lakers at the other end of the ice and then find themselves in that position.
That's number six Fry, a two-minute minor for hooking. That call assessed to 8 minutes, 28 seconds of the third period. Teams are at even strength, 4-on-4.
So 4-on-4 hockey for 16 seconds, and then the Lakers go on their third power play chance. Face-off drawn inside of goaltender Davis Jones as Henke will take it against Josh Eriksson, a pair of number sevens out there for each team. On the draw, Ben Dulles at the right point. Top circle, he works it. Down low to the goal line. Back over now to Henke. Back out top, Ben Dulles. Ben Dulles back for Henke. Right sides it now for Sackerman. Sackerman a pinch in. Blocked down out front, and now the Lakers are on the power play, but the Nanooks will bring it back up the ice. Josh Eriksson playing a little keep away now from neutral ice area back to the zone. Back to Morley, and now Morley will deliver a shot that goes wide left to the goaltender, Dayfield. Wright takes a shot from Eriksson, and now Eriksson will take a penalty. This could be an interesting call coming up. That was a pretty lethal elbow into that Lake State player who's not getting up. This might be a 5-minute major coming up to Josh Eriksson. Wow.
Eriksson might want to head to the locker room right now. That's a...
One thing to be aggressive, but sometimes you can be too aggressive there, and we know it's going to be a 5-on-3 for Lake Superior State, but it could really turn into a lengthy power play opportunity here as they sort this one out here. Penalty comes up at 9:05, and yep, Eriksson is done. He's already heading to the locker room, a 5-and-a game.
You have to be smarter than that. You see a guy's numbers, you're looking right at him, and you're coming in there with that much speed, you cannot hit him. You've got to let up, and we've seen that throughout Eriksson's career. He plays on the edge, and he's going to take some penalties, and that's a bad one right there.
Good news is the Lake Superior State Laker player is up, and that's Aiden Wright, the defenseman, number 22. So good news is he's skating over the bench and not the locker room.
A 5-minute major in game misconduct for checking from behind. That's number seven, Eriksson, a 5-minute major and game misconduct for checking from behind. That penalty will be served by number 18, John Mullally. Time of that call, 9 minutes, 5 seconds of the third period. That'll put the Nanooks on the Denali State Bank 3-on-5 penalty kill.
Well, for a team that had a 2-0 and a 3-1 lead, things could possibly change here quickly. 5-on-3 for a minute 23. And then the 5-minute major will continue after that. So a 2-man advantage now for the Lakers. Down low, they work with it. Coberstown in the penalty kill out there with Brandon Morley and Justin Woods. Morgan to Henke. Back out top now for Sackerman. His shot goes just wide. Henke trying to get to it. A good job as he couldn't get a handle on that one. A chance for the Nanooks to catch a break there. Sackerman getting it back now. Opportunity out front. Nellis with a chance. Davis Jones able to clear that to the corner. Kept alive by Renz. And now, a slashing call and either a slash or interference coming up the Lake State. That will certainly give the Nanooks a little bit of a breather now. It'll be just a 1-man advantage for Lake Superior State. As Nellis.
Did he push the stick of Jones away?
I thought he might have done that. So it's going to be number 19, Nellis, heading to the sin bin at 9:37. Here comes the call.
Taking a seat in the Legacy Funeral Home's penalty box for Lake Superior State, number 19, Anthony Nellis. 2 minutes for interference. That's number 19, Nellis, a 2-minute minor for interference. That call assessed at 9 minutes, 37 seconds of the third period.
All right, so now it's still a 4-on-3 power play chance for Lake Superior State for 45 seconds. The Olympic ice gets even bigger with just 7 skaters on the ice now and the 2 goaltenders. Terrell, side circle, works out front. Back on top, he gets it for Ben Dulles. Back over now to Holtz. Holtz, down low, quick shot. Jones covers up the angle. Back on top, Ben Dulles. Getting it back for Terrell. Back on top for Ben Dulles. Ben Dulles between the circles. Ben Dulles now back over to Mitch Holtz. Holtz will skate with it. Holtz now again puts a shot toward the net. Davis Jones makes a save, and he'll pounce on top of the puck there. A stoppage of play with 9:47 to go.
Great save by Davis Jones there, picking that up through the screen. We had Justin Woods in front of him. We also had one of the, I think it was, trying to figure out who, Kuklieta right in front of him, and able to pick that up and cover it up. Still 4-on-3 for another 16 seconds.
Here's Ben Dulles, back on top for Holtz. Holtz pushed wide there by Van Teetering. Gets it back. Pinches in closer. Rifles a shot. That one bounces around. Still lost out front. Jones can't freeze it. Into the corner is picked up now by LaDuce. Nennister now back to even strength. So 4-4 hockey up the ice. Now to Troy Van Teetering. Van Teetering skates in. Van Teetering wanted to push it out there. And a nice block there by Ben Dulles. So we are going even strength now for 55 seconds, and then it'll be about a 2.5-minute power play as that 5-minute major continues against the Nanooks. Holtz will skate with it. Mitch Holtz now pushed wide there by Woods. Takes it down low now for his teammate, I believe it's Cuglietta. Back out top, they work it for Sackerman. Back over to Renz. Renz back now to Holtz. Holtz with an opportunity goes wide right of goaltender Davis Jones. Picked up again by Sackerman. Right on goal, Davis Jones makes a save. It goes up in the air to the right side of the goal and behind the net, where it's picked up by Zach Fry. 8:50 to go, period three. 3-2 Alaska Nanooks. Still 4-4 hockey. They'll dish it off now to Marcus Becerra. Becerra puts on the brakes, dumps it right out front. That puck nearly got knocked in. Up the ice the other way comes Lake State. They come down 3-on-3. Back to Morgan. Luke Morgan now intercepted Nanooks and then reclaimed by Sackerman at center ice. Morney almost with a takeaway at the neutral ice area. Puck possession changes. Renz now back for Corielli. Right on goal. Davis Jones makes the save. Juggled out front and picked up by Tristan Thompson. And now the Lakers are back on another power play chance as they go now for the better part of 2 minutes plus with an extra skater as the 5-minute major continues against Alaska. We approach 8 minutes to go. Regulation. Alaska Nanooks 3 and the Lake Superior State Lakers 2. Aiden Wright. Good to see him back on the ice. He was the player that got that hard hit back behind the net. He's back out now for the Lakers. They skin and they keep it onside. Nellis now back for Humitz. Back over to Henke. Henke side circle. Power play Lake State right now. Swings it right side for Sackerman. Down low again for Nellis. Back over to Henke. Henke into the circle. Back out top to the point for Sackerman. He'll deliver a shot that actually turns into a pass to the corner. Wright will pick it back up. A minute 40 to go in the power play opportunity now. LaDuce picks it up, can't clear it for Alaska. Henke now out front on the stick of Brandon Morning. He'll clear it up and clear it down. Fresh penalty killers coming up for Alaska. 7:20 to go in the third. Alaska 3, Lake State 2. Power play chance, 90 seconds now for Lake Superior State. Nanooks trying to kill off that 5-minute major. Got a little help with a penalty in the midst of that 5-minute major against Lake State. Lakers quickly up now. With it now is Holtz. Holtz will skate in. Holtz gets it now for his teammate Cuglietta. Make that Cuglietta. Far side it now to Morgan. Back now for Terrell. Back to Cuglietta. Cuglietta behind the goal to the corner for Terrell. Back out tap for Holtz. Holtz will pinch in. Holtz gets it a little closer. Shot goes wide left of Davis Jones. Morgan kept it in right point position. 45 on the power play chance. Van Teetering is able to clear it out to center ice with his teammates. Here's Terrell in front of the Laker bench. Drops it back defensively, and they'll clear it back in the form of Mitch Holtz. Holtz with it, tied up now by Riker Lear. Holtz is able to get it back. Holtz now works out front. There's a bouncing puck, goes right on goal, and with traffic out front, Davis Jones comes up with a big stop to keep it a 3-2 lead for Alaska. 27 seconds left to go in the penalty, being served by John Mullally.
Well, the Lakers have been able to get quite a bit of traffic in front of Davis Jones. And for him, the biggest problem has been able to find that puck through the scramble of players in front of him. But he's done a good job of that.
So here we go. Faceoff draw left side of Davis Jones. 6:22 on the board. 3-2 Nanooks. 27 on the power play for the Lakers. Lakers got the draw. And they can't keep it onside. Pushed out center ice. Sackerman backhands it in. To the puck first, though, is Justin Woods. Woods plays it up front. Look out, takeaway by Aiden Wright. Right now, down to the goal line for Henke. They try to work it to the side wall for Nellis. Nellis has it. Final seconds ticking down. Nellis now, from a tough angle, puts a shot. Jones makes a save to the corner, now to Koberstein. Koberstein can't clear it. Nennister back at full strength. Aiden Wright out front. Front with an opportunity, and Jones gets a piece of that one. As the penalty's over, Nanooks come down now, 2-on-2, trying to turn into a 3-on-2 out front now for Taylor Munson. Lost it, gets it back. Couldn't get a shot on goal. Kept alive though by John Mullally. Back to Munson. Munson to the point. There's Fry with an opportunity. Blocked out, wide open net, backhand shot. What an acrobatic save made by Gordy Dayfield, denying the Nanooks their fourth chance. Here's Morning with a chance. He made the save of the game right there to keep it 3-2 for Lake Superior State. Nellis takes a bump right in front of the player bench area by Morley. Cleared in by John Mullally, but tracked down by Aiden Wright. Natick fans are getting into it, finally helping out the home team here on senior night with 5 minutes to go in regulation, 3-2. 5-on-5 hockey. Renz will dump it in. Onside now for his teammate who tried to work it out there. Basilico. Ryan Basilico with an opportunity. Basilico had the chance. Here's an opportunity now for the Nanics. Ross Height gets it back over now to Colton Leader. Picked up by Gus Corielli. Corielli now plays it up to Renz. Renz will dump it up now for Basilico. Basilico skates in. As they put a shot toward goaltender Davis Jones, he will cover up and stop play with 4:28 to go here in period number 3, 3-2 Alaska. 34 shots on the board for the Lakers, 21 for Alaska.
Check out this save. We're going to get a replay there, but you said save of the game. That might be save of the year. I mean, it was as close to Dominic Hasek as you get. You got to go back to mid-90s to see it. And he was not looking at the puck. He was flying through the air, his back to the play, and I think he got it with his glove hand. Not looking at the puck. That's save of the game. I mean, that's a two-goal lead guarantee for the Nanics just taking off the board. Unbelievable save by Dayfield.
4:28 to go in regulation. Alaska 3, Lake State 2. What's at stake is playoff positioning. Starting tonight, Alaska 6th place, 33 points. Starting tonight, Lake State Northern Michigan tied for 7 with 31. A point better than 9th place Alabama Huntsville and 5 up on last place UAA. For the Nanics, 6th place with 33, 5 back of Ferris State and Bowling Green. A chance to pull within 2 points of those guys. And looking for their 10th conference win. Coaches will be tested here. Players even tested more here in the final 4:28 of regulation. Stay tuned, our post-game press conference coming up here. Coaches, players speak. Corielli Holtz is out there. Troy Van Tienering to take the face-off draw for Alaska against Mitch Holtz. Right side of Davis Jones on the draw. Nanics trying to clear it out. Chatham tries to keep it in. They were going out front for Holtz. Here's Corielli with an opportunity. Goes just wide right at Davis Jones. Right out front, an open opportunity. And somehow, some way, Davis Jones comes back to make a save with a couple of defenders out front. He was down on his stomach there and still able to make a save as the Lakers could not get that puck up in the air.
Got to see a replay.
Man, both these goaltenders standing on their heads here in the last few minutes here.
I'm not sure if Goberstein blocked that. Davis Jones got it, but somehow he made it back to the crease. There was a couple of players there I thought had a chance to block it because I did not think Davis Jones was going to get back there, but some acrobatic goaltending on both ends.
Man, oh man.
Feel how important these points are here with 4:15 left in the game in a one-goal game.
And again, folks, WCHA-TV, you can get it through YouTube right now. UA Hockey at YouTube. If you've been unable to get to it, they understand it's streaming at YouTube right now. It's been confirmed, so. 4:15 to go in the third. Alaska Nanics 3 getting their goals tonight from Josh Erickson, Justin Woods, and Tyler Klein, JT Henke, and Max Humid scoring for Lake Superior. Nanics were able to kill off that 5-minute major penalty. It was broken up by a penalty of their own by Lake State. Senior night here tonight, an emotional night. All that aside now, as both these teams skated under in the final 4:15 of regulation. Mitch Holtz on the draw against the Nanooks. Taylor Munson. And on the faceoff, let's see, they dropped it. They're gonna have to drop it again. Looked like the Nanics had won the faceoff, but nonetheless, it's gonna be dropped again to the right side of Davis Jones.
Hey, look at that shot margin. It sure has widened here in the third period. Lakers 34 shots on goal, the Nanics 21.
And on the draw, Lakers Terrell puts it to the corner. A battle now. picked up by Fry. Shoots it to Klein. He'll dump it up, dump it down. This should be an icing call against the Alaska Nanooks. No, they wave it off. Oh. Munson got back there quick enough to deny the icing call. Clear to the corner. Picked up now by Zach Fry. Fry pinches in from his defensive post. Zach Fry now into the corner to Taylor Munson. Munson taken to the wall. Staley tries to kick it loose. Munson's able to muscle it loose. Munson battling now with Chatham, picked up by Chad Staley. Staley in the circle. Lakers clear it. Up the ice to Gage Terrell. We're down to 3:30 to go in regulation. Alaska 3, Lake State 2. Three big points on the line in the WCHA standings. Nanix will clear it. Here they come up the ice. With it now is Tyler Klein. Poke checked off his stick. Lakers back the other way. Here comes Luke Morgan. Morgan with a nifty move. Back on front. What a save made by Davis Jones. The defender got foiled there as Morgan was able to come in with a backhand opportunity. And Davis Jones earns his keep once again for the Alaska Nanooks.
Yeah, he sure has come up big here in the third period. Right there. Luke Morgan getting a step on the Nanook defenseman in the backhand. And Davis Jones just cutting that off at the side of the net.
Face-off draw right side of Davis Jones. Lakers win it, they score! Nellis has tied up the game at 3-3. Face-off draw win and a one-time shot that gets past Davis Jones. And we got a brand new hockey game with 3:11 to go, period. Number three.
Well, you cannot draw it up any better than that. Face-off draw, Hanke wins it right back to Nellis. And he takes a one-time shot past Davis Jones' glove hand. I don't even think that Davis Jones had a chance to track that one.
Wow.
Turn of events here on their 36th shot on goal.
Season score by number 19, Anthony Nellis. Assisted by number 7, JT Hanke. Time of that even strength goal, 16 minutes, 49 seconds of the third period.
They battle back from a couple of two-goal deficits. Lakers tie it up. Here comes Ross Height back the other way for Colton Leader. Leader down low, side circle. Leader skates with it. Puck taken away by Sackerman. Gets it back to Nellis. Nellis shoots it into the Nanook zone where it's tracked down by Corelli. 2:45 in counting. Third period, we're deadlocked at three goals apiece. Brought in now by Zach Fry. Back into the corner to Kyler Hope. Hope picks it up. Hope now trying to get it back toward Fry. And that puck is into the corner where it's picked up by Aiden Wright. 2:30 on the board. 3-3 score. Lakers with it. Brought in now by Diego Cuglietta. Gets past a would-be check. Nanook's now with a second opportunity. Will clear it out to center ice. A battle for the puck. Shot back in by the Lakers and tracked down by Nicholas Koberstein. We approach 2 minutes to go in regulation. Tied at three goals apiece. Here's Kyler Hope. Losing it to Mitch Holtz. Holtz at center ice. Holtz now backhands it in. It'll be stopped by Davis Jones behind his net. He'll play it back defensively now to his teammate, Koberstein. Nicholas Koberstein. Here's a shot opportunity there by Munson, and a save made by the goaltender. Left a long rebound out there as Taylor Munson had a chance. Corielli battling height. Taken away Nanooks. Pass did not connect as Hultz will take it away. Hultz now for Terrell. Woods will get to it first. Justin Woods now with 1:40 on the clock in regulation. 3-3 score. Up to Staley, too hot to handle. Sackerman takes it away at the blue line. Gets it over now for Terrell. Gage Terrell, stirred in now by Bendulis. Line change now for a couple of players. Picked up by Corelli, up to Chad Staley. Staley lost it to Hanke, he'll shoot it back in. 1:20 to go in the third period, 3-3 score. Up now to Sackerman, he lost it, a race for the puck, and Aiden Wright will get to it first with pressure from Tyler Klein. Up to Aiden Wright. They'll flip it back out. It was actually Sackerman to try to clear it out. Sackerman picks it back up now to Luke Morgan. Morgan skates dangerously in front of his own net with 1 minute to go in regulation. Here comes Morgan motoring once again. Morgan with a backhand shot goes just wide of Davis Jones. Marcus Passara able to clear it up the ice now. A bit too far for Tyler Morley. Bendulis back for the Lakers. Onside now for Morgan. Morgan skates with it. Morgan now gets in. He's taken off the play by Tristan Thompson. Hanke will keep it alive back for Morgan. They work it out front. Intercepted by the Nanooks. Passara and cleared nicely now by Zach Fry. Fry motors in. Right point position. Dumps it toward the corner where Basaras will battle back behind the net. A battle for it now between Chatham and Troy Van Tindering and Basara. 30 on the clock. Here's Hanke. He'll flip it up, taken away by Corelli back at the Nanook blue stripe. Corelli back now for Koberstein. Koberstein fanned on it. Humitz will bring it back in now for Lake Superior State. Humitz works out front. Nice takeaway there by Danny Corelli. 10 seconds to go in regulation. Dumped out center ice. A battle for it now as Cugliana skates in. Diego Cugliana taken wide there. They'll dump it back behind the Nanak net. Here's Humitz with one opportunity here, and we're going to head to overtime, folks. 5 minutes sudden death overtime coming up here as this game is tied at 3-3. Two third period goals off the sticks of Max Humitz and Anthony Nellis have tied this game at 3-3. And what we'll do now is we'll put five on the overtime board here. And if somebody scores within that five-minute span, they will be declared the winner. If we do not have a winner after 5 minutes, the game will be declared an NCAA tie. We will go to a 3-on-3 overtime for 5 minutes. Nobody scores there. Then we go to a shootout for WCHA purposes. So we still have 3 points on the line as we'll put 5 minutes on the board here, Eric Dragas.
Just think about just under 5 minutes left in the game, and Dayfield makes that diving save. Well, I mean, it's the best save I've seen here in the Carlson Center this season. And that would have made the game 4-2. And a couple minutes later, they win that faceoff. And Nellis makes a 3-3 hockey game. I mean, Dayfield at one point in this hockey game had allowed 3 goals on 5 shots. And I was looking up at the scoreboard, and there was about 4 minutes left in the first period. And I was wondering, are we going to see a goaltending change on the next goal or at the beginning of the second period? And he stayed in the game. He's gutted it out, and he made, I mean, save of the year there in the third period. It gave him life, and a great faceoff win by Hanke, and Anthony Nellis able to put it in the net, and that's why we're at 3-3 here and heading into this overtime period.
Trying to see if we can pull up the shots and goal in that third period of play. The unofficial shots that I've got right now were 8-4 for Lake Superior State, but that's... They're saying 29-20 for the Lakers, so I don't know. Those numbers not even close to what we've got on the scoreboard here. All right, overtime, 5 minutes on the board, so here we go.
19-8. Lake State is what I've got on the college hockey app.
Man, you got that quicker than I did. So 19-8, huh? All right, here we go. We're going to face it off. First goal here wins it in overtime. They switch ends. Chatham back to Ben Dulis, back to Holtz. Holtz top of the circle. Holtz now had it taken away by Woods. They got Tyler. Oh, they had Tyler Klein a step away from a breakaway opportunity. Back the other way comes Holtz. Holtz will skate in. Holtz puts on the brakes between the circles. Quick shot. Davis Jones will snare that one with a left glove save to keep it a 3-3 tie 21 seconds in. It goes quickly. An opportunity for Klein to have a breakaway opportunity blocked down by Lake State. They come back with a great scoring chance and a nice save made by Davis Jones.
Oh, nobody wants to make a mistake now. But on the other hand, everybody wants to be a hero. It's nervous. Nervous hockey, you see it the first 21 seconds.
So 21 seconds to go, or 21 seconds into the period. Face-off draw. Up the ice comes Klein. Klein will skate with it. Gets it back now for Zach Fry. Taken to the corner and back behind the net. It will go. With 4:18 to go in the overtime session. Puck cleared in. Opportunity now for Nellis. It's taken wide. Back to the point now for Sackerman. Sackerman gets it down to the goal line now for Hanke. Hanke shoots with it. Hanke tries to work with it. Back out top. Nanix will work it out. Here's a chance for Hanke. Back the other way. Knocked down by the Nanix. Riker Lear. Lear had it stripped away at center. And with 3:40 to go, both teams out at the neutral ice area. Poke checked away by Riker Lear. 3:32 to go. Here comes Sackerman. Dumps it toward goaltender Jones. Taken wide, not there. Here comes Mullally getting it up now to Brandon Morley. Morley skates with it. Blocker save made by the goaltender, Gordy Dayfield. Back out top for Corelli. Now we get an offsides call, they believe, whistled down against the Alaska Nanooks.
Hot potato there in the neutral zone. That puck bouncing around. neither team really able to get a handle on it there in the neutral zone.
3:14 to go in the overtime session. As we'll face it off at the center ice area. to go, still tied at 3-3 here in the overtime session. The Alaskan Enix and the Lake Superior State Lakers overtime at the Carlson and Fairbanks. Corielli trying to take it away. Into the far wall, Marcus Basara has it. Basara skates with it. Here's Justin Woods losing it. Corielli takes it away now for Lake Superior State. A battle now with Troy Van Teetering in the right-hand corner. Woods has the puck. Woods now back behind his own net, trying to feed it for Marcus Basara. Back behind the goal, it's Corielli, dumped it out front, taken away by Troy Van Teetering. Van Teetering getting it back to Marcus Basara. Basara skates in, drops it back for Brandon Morley. Morley with an opportunity, save made by Dayfield. Dayfield makes the save. Up the ice now for Morgan. Morgan skates with it. Morgan now, side of the circle. Pushed wide there with 2:21 to go. Back on top, bouncing puck and goal, save made by goaltender Davis Jones. So Davis Jones with the opportunity.
Well, Danner's had a chance down there, and Brandon Morley making a smart play. Just get the puck to the net. And Dayfield took away the bottom of the net. I believe it was Van Teetering heading to the net. Wasn't able to get a stick on that. A quiet crowd. When they were up 3-1, not expecting this to be an overtime right now.
Opportunity now for Nellis. Picked up Nanook, so dump it out center ice. Here comes Chad Staley. Staley with a puck, he'll clear it back in. Back now behind the goal. It's Taylor Munson. Munson works it out front. Morgan will intercept. Morgan will take it away. Morgan now works with the puck. Henke shoots it back in. 1:52 to go in the overtime session. Back now with it. It is Klein. Klein skates with it. Klein shoots it in. Picked up by Bendulis. 1:34 to go in the overtime session. And we'll work with now to Chatham. Chatham behind his own goal. Plays it up to Henke. Henke getting it back for Corelli. Corelli has it. And they'll get it.
For me, you can really tell that neither team wants to make a mistake. And they're both out of gas. A lot of guys bending over, trying to catch their breath. This is a long hockey game, long weekend. And then to go to overtime with this much on the line, trying to get points to make it in the playoffs. It's just it's really tightened up here in this overtime.
1:12 to go in the overtime session. We've now lost the radio feed. We do apologize. So if you're watching us, we've got it on WCHAT. We've now lost the radio feed here, and we're going to try to give the radio station a call. 1 minute to go. Shot on goal, save made by Gordy Dayfield. We're down to 55 seconds to go. So 55 seconds to go in the overtime session. Still tied at 3-3. Opportunity for the Nanix. Blocked down. And the puck is cleared up. And cleared out. I'm plugged into power. So 32 seconds to go in the session. And we're going to try to get hooked up through the cell phone. Okay, so we're trying to. All right, here we go. 3-3 score. All right, 3-3 score here on WCHA-TV. Final seconds are ticking down. Looks like we're going to be heading to a 3-on-3 overtime session. And they'll work with it. Puck cleared out. And this game is going to end in a 3-3 tie. Each team now going to be guaranteed at least 1 point in the WCHA standings. As Fry skates it in. All right, we apologize. We're back on the air as far as radio goes here. We lost that radio feed about 5 minutes. It's just been a nightmare with technical issues here tonight. We have now played 5 minutes of overtime. We are tied at 3-3. And each team has now been guaranteed at least 1 point in the WCHA standings. So 1 point for each team. And now we will go to a three-on-three overtime shootout. So a three-on-three overtime shootout, Eric Dragas. It should be very, very interesting.
Yeah, we have. We haven't gotten to an overtime game at home since Omaha and Canisius were here. And a lot of overtime games on the road, but each team earning a point. And for Lake Superior State, when they saw themselves down 3-1, probably a little bit worried, but able to fight back and still go back to save by Dayfield, keeping it at a 3-2 hockey game. And they're able to knot it up at 3-3.
Yeah, see, that'll work. All right, again, we're working with a jury-rigged system here. We're going to try to get the Comrex unit back on. We do apologize. As we are looking at a 3-3 tie. So each team's been guaranteed at least a point here in the WCHA standings, and now the unit won't even fire up, will it? Wow. Maybe some static electricity up here in the booth. I don't know. So 3-on-3 hockey coming up. Let me...
Both teams have got to be winded. You see a lot of guys just bent over. The Nanooks are without Josh Erickson, the guy who sees a lot of ice time, especially
yes, killing, he does.
Killing penalties, some power play, and it just took an ill-advised bad penalty there in the third period, the hippie from behind, and that was the end of his career on home ice.
All right, so again, we apologize here. We're now trying to find some AC up here. Oh, my goodness. Eric, I'm going to have to cut you out here. I do apologize.
Okay.
We're going to have to cut you out here. So we'll do this, and we will do this. My battery power's down to 10%. We do apologize, ladies and gentlemen, but we're still here. Play back in, 3-on-3 overtime session for Alaska here. As the Nanooks buzzer on, there's a shot on goal and a save made by Gordy Dayfield. Dayfield comes up with a big, big save. Brought in now by Chad Staley. Staley skates with it, out front now, opportunity for the Nanooks, and the shot goes just off the mark there by Zach Fry. So Fry just misses the opportunity. Just misses the opportunity by Zach Fry. We got 4:10 to go in the 3-on-3 overtime session here as the Nanooks trying to see if they can pick up 2 points in the WCHA standings. 3-3 score here. WCHA TV will get radio back on air here in just a couple of seconds. With it now is Klein. Klein skates with it. Back now to Justin Woods. Woods will skate with it. Woods up to Marcus Passara. Puck taken away now by Mitch Holtz. Holtz skates back in for Lake Superior State. He fires it just wide. So Holtz shot goes just wide. 3:40 to go in the overtime session here. The 3-on-3 overtime session. We're still tied at 3-3. As both these teams are guaranteed at least 1 point tonight in the WCHA standing. So guaranteed at least 1 point. Up the ice, he'll skate. Well, there comes Marcus Passara. Dishes off now for Tyler Klein. Klein comes in and a save made by goaltender Gordy Dayfield. 3:20 to go. Up the ice, Justin Woods takes it away from Gage Terrell. He'll skate with it. Puck brought in now by Passara. He'll drop it back to Justin Woods at center ice. 3:10 to go in the overtime session. The 3-on-3 overtime session. Again, both teams guaranteed a point. Another point still on the table. Up the ice comes Brandon Morley. Morley skates in. Drops it back for Troy Van Teetering. Van Teetering down low. Getting it back now for Morley. Morley down deep. He'll take it back now for Troy Van Teetering. 3-on-3 hockey. Troy Van Teetering pushed to the wall there by Gus Corielli. Luke Morgan's got it, and now back the other way. They've got a chance to turn it to a 2-on-1 as Morgan comes down the ice now with Sackerman. Morgan with a shot, blocked down nicely there by Zach Fry. Kept alive at the point there by Luke Morgan. Morgan skates with it. Morgan now comes out front. Morgan with a backhand shot. They score, and the Lake Superior State Lakers will pick up the extra point in the 3-on-3 overtime as they win it here by a score of 4-3. A backhand opportunity as the Lakers paddle back from a couple of two-goal deficits. They'll pick up 2 points in the WCHA standings, while Alaska will pick up one in the standings. So, wow. A bittersweet ending here on senior night for the Alaska Nittany team with a couple of two-goal leads in this one. They lose a tough one, 4-3, in the overtime session. Both teams will shake hands at center ice, and I think this will be a more of a civil handshake than we saw in last night's contest. So what does that do for the standings right now? It basically means Alaska goes to 34 points, and Lake Superior State goes to 33. So Alaska's still sixth. Lake State now in sole possession of seventh place, and Northern Michigan now in eighth place with 31 points. So if the playoffs started tonight, Alabama, Huntsville, and UAA would be on the outside looking in. So 3-3 NCAA final, 4-3 decision for the Lakers in the 3-on-3 double overtime session. We're going to wrap things up, I believe, for our TV broadcast right now. And we'll probably wrap it up for WYSS 99.5 in Sault Ste. Marie with the technical issues we had here during the last 5 minutes of play. But nonetheless, it's a big victory here for the Lake Superior State Lakers as they come up victorious. Well, technically, it's an NCAA 3-3 tie, but we say a 4-3 decision for the Lake Superior State Lakers. And I got to admit, I didn't even get credit for who scored that game-winning goal for the Lakers. All right, stay tuned. We'll come back for a quick wrap-up on the radio side of things. Let's come back in just 60 seconds. This is Alaska Nittany Hockey in the simulcast, ESPN Radio, 820 Sports, KCBF, and 99.5 SFM.
over, but I I freaking hate those things. I mean, it's been bulletproof for me up to now. I wonder if it wasn't static electricity. But all of a sudden, I'm sitting that thing, you know? Fucking disaster. Then I guess those guys tried to pick up the feed on that on the internet.
Oh, I know. What, you mean last night?
Yeah, last night. They found an alternative, they thought, going to U.S. Screens or something.
Oh, I wish you would have known last night.
I didn't know that because I just...
Yeah, I could ask Chris to look at it today.
I just got the word tonight, so he didn't tell me.
Is that hurt us there?
No, we're still in sixth place. It is hurt, so we're not going to get...
3 points would have been better.
Oh, hell yeah. I don't think we're going to catch Ferris State now. Don't think we're going to get number 5. I think we're going to go to Minnesota State. We go to 34, 33, 31, 30. God damn it. I saw this, it went to, the screen went great.